Next test we have a testing of isolators and the circuit breaker. So in this section, the both isolators and circuit breakers which is going to be considered will give an common characteristics for the both. So while these characteristics are relevant to the testing of the both circuit breakers, and they are not much relevant as far as the testing of the isolators are concerned, since isolators are not used for interrupting a high currents, they interrupt very small amount of the current of the order of a 0.5 amperes, which may be capacitive current of the bushings, bus bar, etc. In fact, there is a definition for the isolator or the disconnectors as per International Standard 19921, Part 1, 1981, which is as follows. So that is nothing but the isolator, the definition. So this is the isolator or disconnector is a mechanical switching device which provides in the open position and isolating distance in accordance with a special requirement. So as an isolator which is capable to open as well as the closing of the circuit when either there is a negligible current is broken or made, or when there is no significant change in the voltage across the terminal of the each pole of the isolator occurs. So this is also capable of carrying the current under normal circuit condition and carrying a specified time currents under abnormal condition. As such, those of the short circuit will take places. Detail about this, which is explained by IS 9921 Part 1, 1981, and this is subjected to that a small amount of the current of 0.5, a capacitive current. Then there is a circuit breaker, which is nothing but on load or the high load current breaking switches. So testing of these things by considering of the summarization of the circuit breakers, the basically we have to test there are the two things, that is construction and operating characteristics and the electrical characteristics. So there are the different type of the test which is going to be summarized, which is explained as below. That is nothing but the first one, we have the electrical characteristics. So in that, which is going to determine the arcing voltage, a current chopping circuits, current chopping characteristics, residual currents, rate of decrease of the conductance of the arc space and the plasma, shunting effects in the interruption. So it means that you should have a broad idea of what you mean by arcing voltage and the residual current, then the what you mean by a arc interruption, all those things. Then coming to that, the other physical characteristics are the arc extinguished media. So we have different type of media, like so vacuum or in that air gap we have SF6, okay, into all the different compositions. Then what is the pressure developed at a point of the interruption? Then what is the speed of the contact traveling? Then number of the breakers which you're going to use. Then size of the arcing chamber. So this is subjected to that what is the pressure which is exerted between the two columns. Then what is the material and configuration of the circuit interruption. Then basically we are going to characterize the circuit which is includes that is a degree of electrical loading, applied voltage, type of the fault, what is the time of the interruption, what is the frequency, then power factor, rate of rise of recovery voltage, and the race tracking voltage. This is very important. So if you could be able to minimize the race tracking voltage, then there is an increase in the dielectric strength of the chamber, means the medium, no, takes places. Then decrease in AC component of the short circuit current, then DC component of the short circuit current. To assess these factors, the main test which is going to conduct on the breakers and the isolator switches are the dielectric test or the overvoltage test, the next temperature rate test, mechanical test, and the short circuit test. So we can discuss one by one. That is dielectric test. It is consist of the overvoltage switch and test of the power frequency, lightning, and the switching impulse voltages. This is tested for internal and the external insulation of the circuit breaker with both open and the closed position. Generally, the voltage in the open position will be of 15% greater than that of the closed position. So during the test, the circuit breaker which is mounted on the insulator above the ground to avoid a ground failure, because there is a possibility of the grounding may take place when we apply the over voltage than the rated voltage. So then we have impulse test. So with the lightning impulse wave of the standard shape, which is done, which is similar as the case of the insulators. So in addition to that, the switchings are the test with the switching over voltage are also done on the circuit breaker and the isolator to assess their performance under over voltage due to the switching operations. So then we have thermal test and the mechanical test. These are the type test on the circuit breaker and are done according to the specification. Generally, to check the behavior of the breakers, so continuously, so there is a temperature rise must not be exceeded 40 degrees Celsius when it is under a rated normal current which is of less than 800 amperes, and 50 degrees Celsius if it is of 800 amperes and the above. So these are the different type of the test which is going to be conducted on the isolators and the circuit breakers. Next one, we have mechanical test. This test which is done to ensure open and closing without any mechanical failures. So at least it is of required a 500 operation without any failures. Sometimes it is 20,000 operations as well with no adjustment of the mechanism. So resulting in there is a change in the material or a dimension of the particular component may considerably improves the life and the efficiency of the mechanism. So next one, we have important one, that is a short circuit test. So in that there are the two different types, that is direct test and the synthetic test. So this test basically is to check the ability of the safely interrupt the fault currents. So since these tests assess the primary performance of the devices, that is their ability to safely interrupt the fault current. So this consists of determining the making and the braking capacity at a different load current and the voltages. So in the case of the isolator, the short circuit tests are conducted only with a limited purpose to determine their efficiency to carry the rated short circuit current for the given duration, and there is no breaking or making the current the test which is done. So these are the methods of conducting short circuit, that is DARA test and the synthetic test. So in that, the first one is in the DARA test using the power utility as a source, second one using the short circuit generator as the source. Then other than that, we have a synthetic test. So that is nothing but in the synthetic test we have first one, that is a direct test. This is a test which is using the power utility as the source. So in that, the circuit breakers are sometimes tested for their ability to make or the break of the circuit under normal load condition or under short circuit condition in the network itself. So we wanted to check directly. So how does this will behave? So this is done during the period of limited energy consumption, or when there is an electrical energy which is diverted to the other sections of the network which are not connected to the circuit under test. So these are the advantages. That is nothing but the tested under actual condition in the network. The special cases like making and breaking or charge current, long lines, very short lines, fault, etc. can be tested. So thermal and dynamic effect of the short circuit current and application of the safety devices can be studied. So these are the things. We'll assess the thermal and dynamic effect of the short circuit current and to study the application of the safety devices and to revise the performance of the test procedure. These are some of the limitations we have. Can be tested only in the rated voltage and capacity of the network. The test is done only at a light load condition. And extra inconvenience and expenses in the installation of the control and measuring equipment is required to conduct the field test, because we are going to conduct this kind of a test directly. The second one is direct testing, short circuit test in the laboratory. So in order to test these circuit breakers at different voltages at a different short circuit current, the short circuit laboratory which is provided, this is the arrangement. So it consists of a short circuit generation which is in association with the master circuit breaker, which you can see here. There is a breakup circuit breaker, resistors, reactors and measuring devices. So these are the setups: short circuit generator, you can see, master circuit breakers, resistors, reactors, okay, and measuring devices, which is connected CT, PT as well, all those things. So here the make switch initiate the short circuit and master circuit will isolate the test device from the source at the end of the predetermined time. So it means that initially this making switch will be get closed and this is also get closed. So what is the energy associated with the short circuit generator and the reactor will transfer to the test devices. So then it is fully tested for both the high voltage and the high current. So if it is could not able to isolate by the making switch, then backup breaker or the master circuit breaker will come into the action and this will isolate the circuit from the source. So this is the direct testing in the laboratory means. So here we can able to test for the both high voltage and the high current applications. Next one we have synthetic testing. So due to that very high interrupting capacity of the circuit breakers, it is not economical to have a single source which is capable to provide short circuit and the rated voltage. So hence we are considering that effect of short circuit, which is obtained as regarded as intensity of the current, and the recovery voltage as a combination of the effect of these two sources. So one of the which is supplies the current, another one which supplies the high voltage. So there is the initial period of the short circuit test. The current source which supplies the heavy current at a low voltage, and then the recovery voltage which is simulated by the source of the comparatively high voltage of small current capacity. the schematic diagram which is shown here. This is what low voltage and the recovery high voltage at a small current. So means, so both we are supplying the high current and the high voltage. So let's see how does this actually the circuit diagram and works. Okay, you can see this is the high voltage, high current source, and this is the high voltage source. So initially, at the time, the T1 which we are considering that, okay, before the T1, so with the auxiliary breaker, this is a 3, and the test breaker T, this is a T, the closing of the making switch, the 1, this will lead to that there is a current which is flowing into the circuit breaker. Okay, this is a circuit breaker where we have, at the instant, this is a T0 value which you are considering. Okay, the test breaker, this is a T, begins to operate, and the master circuit breaker, this is a 1, is ready to clear the generator circuit. Okay, so it means that the current, high current, which is flowing into the circuit. After the sometimes, this is the operation where we can call it as, okay, so when this is a close 3 and the 1, 4 and the T, okay, it starts supplying, okay, the T0, and it starts initiating to the till the value of the T1. Okay, at sometimes after the T1, this is subjected to T1, this is a point just before it is going to become a 0 of the current, means the generator current, the tripping gap, this is the 6 3 electrode gap arrangement what we discussed in the previous model. Okay, closes, this is initiate, and the high frequency current from the discharge capacitor, this is the CV, will flow through the circuit, this is the arc, at the time of T2. Okay, at the time of T2, so when there is a current is 0, okay, this is a 0 means by this switch 1, the circuit breaker 1 will clear the circuit, and this will leave only the part of the CV, so which has required for the rate of the change of the current at its 0, which is flowing. So at this time, a full voltage and the full current which is available across the test offset. After this, the closing of the gap, this is 6, would be a little earlier in the time compared to this, okay, at the time, but it has been shown here by the graph. So it is very important to see to that there is a high current source is disconnected and high voltage source which is applied with absolute precision. So this is done by auxiliary circuit breaker at the instant of a circuit breaker. Means just I will once again briefly explain this. 3 and the 4 get close and there is a T. Okay, and this is start flowing by the T0 value. So when there is a 1 is closes, short circuit value will start flowing into the circuit. Okay, at this point T1, before it is reaching to 0, this 3 electrode gap arrangement is conducted, and what is the value, the high voltage which is supplied by the CV will start flowing into the circuit. So before it is starting 0, there is a high current, high voltage which is start flowing into that. So it is associated both the high voltage and the high current at this the time T1 and the T2. So this is how actually we are going to test the circuit breaker and the isolator in the synthetic testing. So other than this, we have a composite testing and the unit testing and the asymmetry test. Okay, so this is what are the different methods for testing of isolator and the circuit breakers.